Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our challenge runs here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Rebirth series. Today we're going to be doing the You Can't Refuse Anything challenge, which basically means any and all consumables that drop on the ground I have to take, including pills, tarot cards, etc. The only exception is that I don't have to take a pill or a card that could kill me, like Suicide King. I don't have to do that. But everything else is fair game. I have to take it, even if it's like, say, we find like a health down pill, and I find another one on the same floor, and I only have two hearts left. I have to take that. That is why it's the challenge. So, without further ado, let's get hopping right onto it. Thank you, everyone, who's been giving me your ideas for the challenge runs. I do appreciate it. Obviously, that last one didn't go too well, and hopefully this one will go a little bit better. Here's your seed today. It's going to be Bravo 1 Alpha Sierra 97 Sierra Golf. So, yeah, if we find a pill that does something like Bad Trip, if we find something that, say, is a Tears Down or Speed Down, I have to take it no matter what. Even if it's bad, even if I know it's bad, I still have to take it. Chemical Peel, it's not very good. It's not very bad, but it's okay. That being said, that is the only part of this challenge, however, so I am allowed to take anything else. I'm allowed to get deals with the devil, angels, etc. I should also mention right now that I don't have to buy anything that's in the shop. So if there's like a pill in the shop, I am not obligated to buy that. I simply, if I don't have the money, it's just a regular choice at that point. Let's put it that way. I'm not obligated to buy something that in the shop. A couple of people mentioned like a smart shopper or supermarket sweep sort of channel, whatever the heck the name of the TV show that they're referencing, where basically I would have to buy everything that's in the shop. But honestly, I don't want to. Even if I have the bombs, like, I don't want to nuke my donation machine, because that's kind of detrimental to the, once we're done with the challenge runs. I'm still planning on doing the culmination, the ultimate challenge, which will be every single challenge that we've done in this series for the next, I think we have 6 more episodes left, where we do all those all at once. And that's going to be very interesting, to say the least. Got Jesus Juice. Again, we don't have, both Jesus Juice and Chemical Peel are too mediocre for me to reroll right now. So we'll see. What would also be hilarious is if I didn't, like, find any pills in this run, which almost is inconceivable, but we've seen crazier things happen. Super Gluttony. It's kind of a weird boss to see on the first floor game. There we go, and he drops Lard, which I don't actually want because I don't want the movement speed down. Reroll that. We get Sister Maggie. Another challenge that people were talking about me possibly doing would be like the you have to pick up all followers that you see. And honestly, that's like the family reunion or the family man challenge that's actually built into the game. So I don't think that anyone would really be interested in seeing something that's already kind of there, if that makes sense. Like, if you give me your ideas and I happen to shoot them down, don't take it personally. I have to do what I think would be A, fun for everybody to watch, and B, something that's unique and different. I'll grab the Humbling Bundaboo because it is a fantastic item, and we could theoretically get enough money here. It's not going to be enough. Just barely not enough. But I can buy that other soul heart, and I'm okay with that. I would have liked to have gotten the blue map. That's all right. We end up getting the Humbling Bundle, and that's good enough for me, man. And again, I do appreciate everyone giving their advice, giving their ideas for custom challenges. Hopefully in Afterbirth. Hopefully they build it to where you can make your own challenges in the game. I talked about this yesterday, I believe. I think that would be cool that we can make our own custom challenges for ourselves or for like fans of the game or whatever, you know. That would be pretty neat. This is Scream Secret Room. Yep. So we are going to be able to get into the Curse Room here. I'm pretty happy about that. Humbling Bundle already paying for itself. And let's just rock and roll in the Curse Room. It's going to be Contract from Below. Wow. So Contract from Below plus Humbling Bundle equals we don't have any consumable problems ever again, ever. We are basically rich at this point. Contract from Below doubles the drops that happen in a room naturally. And combine that with Humbling Bundle, which gives you +1/+1, meaning that coins, keys, bombs, hearts, some hearts anyway, will drop double the amount. So you combine that, you just double it. It's a lot of it's a lot of items that we no longer have to worry about. What's even nicer is if we get like a bunch of soul hearts. Double chests, and there's our first pill. Let's go ahead and see what it is. Tears up. I think I'll be happy with that. And a dime. My word, man. We're getting pretty hooked up on this run so far. I'm not gonna complain about it. Gonna be sloth. By the way, I should also mention that if a tarot card drops or a pill drops, I don't have to take it right then and there. I can use it whenever I want, but the stitch up is I'm not allowed to leave the floor without taking it. That's one of the two constraints to that. The other one being that I don't have to take something that would kill me. Two pills, huh? Well, let's go do the boss first before we hop onto those pills, because we have no idea what those are going to be. Could be good, could be bad. Oh yeah, we have no keys. I can see forever, alright. Let's might as well leave that now. There's no picky, you can't pick and choose which ones, which and where. It's a good death card room. You cannot choose where and when. Well, you can choose when you use your pills. You cannot choose where, however. As in, like, you can't choose it to do it on the next floor. You have to take them before leaving the floor. I'm not going to reroll Swarm Protector yet. Steam Sail is a pretty good pickup, especially given the fact that we just are completely rich right now. I don't mind Swarm Protector. I will go pick it up. But first, I want to see what's inside of our boss room here. It's going to be Blighted Ovum. It's not a very good matchup for Blighted Ovum, I gotta say. Code Hanger, too good to reroll. Deal with the Devil is going to be three red chests, and they all have spiders in them. Alright, so now the question is, do we re-roll what's in the shop, or do we re-roll Swarm Protector? I like Swarm Protector, I really do. And since we don't have to worry about money, I think that it'd be worthwhile for us to at least use one re-roll on the shop. Plus, I can go play that the Blood Bank, which I should do anyway. So, Bago Bomb's not going to need. Soul Converter, definitely not going to need. I hope we don't need it anyway. I reroll Swarm Protector and we get the soul, which is not very good. Yeah, I said it. I don't think the soul's that great. It's not worth the effort it took to unlock it. Let's put it that way. It's okay. Like, so what the soul does... Okay. What the soul does, it will force projectiles to move away from Isaac in a very, very, very slow pattern. Like, it's not like a force field where it just blocks everything. It's not like you have a permanent triple orbital. It will sometimes change the trajectory of incoming projectiles. Sometimes, not always. Usually not ever, but that's just me. So, no deal with Devil Precedence, and I'm actually okay with that. Our tiers rate is great, thanks to the tiers uphill that we got, plus the wire code hanger. But that could change in an instant. You never know when we hit those tiers down, man. Even if like four or five tiers down pills drops, I have to take them. Which makes this challenge very interesting. Because it doesn't matter how big and strong we get. If we get a couple of really bad pills, man, that I have to take, whew, it can turn around in a heartbeat. Not gonna go in the mob trap room. Someone also, there was a post, somebody mentioned that I should do a full clear run, which basically means I clear every single floor. I don't know if I would really find that all that challenging. I mean, it might be challenging depending on what the items you got. And I guess that's, you can summarize every single run in Isaac as it all depends on what items you get sort of thing. But I think that that would just make for a very long and very boring video. So yeah. If I shoot down one of your ideas, I'm not doing it specifically. It's not a personal attack. I'm just giving you my opinion on it. We've had some great challenge ideas. We've had some not so great challenge ideas. But I do appreciate the support. I appreciate that you took the time out of your busy schedules to give me ideas to help improve the series and make something entertaining for you all fine nerd and nerdettes to watch here on YouTube. That just looks like a... Nope, never mind. I was going to say, this really looks like a secret room. It might not be. We have two keys, which is surprising that we're even saying that we're short on something, but we actually do not have a lot of keys. Come on, man. There we go. Got a soul heart. Surprised that there wasn't a second one in there, but that's okay. Mongo baby. I like Mongo baby. I don't know why, I just do. By the way, this is something I did not know about Mongo Baby until very, very recently. I did not realize that Mongo Baby emulates what kind of followers you have. So, as you see here, Mongo Baby is not shooting the standard white tiers that he usually does. He's actually shooting Sister Maggie tiers. That goes for everything. If we had Little Gish, he'd be shooting the same exact type of tiers that Little Gish shoots. And that, again, that's not something that I knew about Mongo Baby until very, very recently. Starter deck. I'm going to take the starter deck just because I want the extra card room. And haha, not going to be taking that. Again, the only way that I don't do that, or the only way that I take that is if we had extra lives. Two of spades. Get hearts and keys. I'm happy about that. I guess an unintended side effect, now that I think about it, of taking starter deck is that all pills actually turn into tarot cards, so... Well, we didn't have any... I think we only had one... Did we have a bad pill? I don't even remember now. I know we had tears up. Was there another one in there that we took? Honestly, don't remember. It doesn't matter now. We're not going to have any more pills. So let's go do the boss. It's going to be Chad. If we get an extra life in a Deal with the Devil room, I will go back and use the Suicide King. Little Chad. Don't want him. Experimental treatment. Don't really want that either. I just don't. I really don't. We did not get a Deal with the Devil or Deal with the Angel, which is actually quite surprising because we didn't take really hardly any damage on that last floor. Sneaky contract from below. And we have the High Priestess. You see our damage is still pretty decent, but that's mostly attributed to the really high fire rate that we have. Trying to get as much money as possible here. We do have the Steam sale, so I literally can buy anything and everything that's in the shop for the rest of the run. Let's go back and see what's in the boss trap room here. Give me a soul heart and a half heart. I'll just get rid of Chubb right away. Peep shouldn't be a problem. Our range is actually pretty decent. And Mongo Baby and Sister Maggie are going pretty much ham bone on a plate on the Peep here. There we go, easy peasy. I could have taken that half heart. I guess there's no reason why I shouldn't, but... Same time, doesn't really matter because if we get a Deal with the Devil, I'll go ahead and trade it away. Although I have a sneaky suspicion that we're going to be getting a Deal with the Angel here on this run, or this floor anyway. Again, at the end of our challenge week here, I believe we have five or six more episodes left for the challenge. I think we actually have six. I will be doing the ultimate challenge run, which is going to be a combination of every single challenge that we've done in the series. So a combination of the spacebar override challenge, a combination of the you can only take deals with the angel challenge, you can't refuse challenge, and the no red HP challenge. All that, plus whatever other crazy challenges I end up committing on for the rest of this week will be going into the ultimate challenge, which is doing all of them simultaneously. That should be pretty kooky. That should be a very interesting run. I'm not expecting to win all these challenges. Admittedly, this challenge isn't that difficult to begin with. It just all comes down to if we get bad pills or not. It could have been bad. And obviously, I don't have to worry about pills anymore because I took the starter deck. Which, to be quite honest, that was not a cheese move. I didn't even consider that. That's one of the few items in the game that I legitimately forget that I have. It's an unintended side effect, let's put it that way. Got a Hierophant card. It's good. I have to use both of these before we leave the floor. So if we can get a big room for the Cards Against Humanity, I will be happy about that. I've not found our item room or our item shop. There we go. So there's our room. Somebody mentioned the other day about the golden challenge, which you can only, the golden door challenge, which basically means that you can only take items that you find in item rooms, period. You can't take boss items, you can't take deals with the devil or angels, and you also can't take shop items. And that would seem pretty challenging. So we may be doing that one next. That one's kind of crazy, though. It's going to be hard to combine that one with the rest of them when we do the ultimate challenge. The Proc Magic Motion here, which I think is hilarious. So Sharp Plug and Pandora's Box. I pretty much am going to buy everything here. Pandora's Box should give us, I believe, an item. Yeah, it's going to be Old Bandage. Don't really want Old Bandage. I might as well use the deck of cards here. And we get the World card. All right, so I'm going to use the Hierophant just to get it out of our inventory. Use that. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We will not have enough for another reroll in the shop, unfortunately. I'll go ahead and see what these tarot cards are. This one is the Fool card. And this one is the Emperor card. Okay, so let's use the Emperor card now. Well, I'm going to use the Emperor card. Let me grab the full charge first. Then we use the Emperor card. It's going to be Gertie. I wonder what would happen if you... I'm just going to use it now. Can Gertie actually hit us from there? I don't think any of Gertie's shots will be able to hit us. Yeah. It's completely blocked by the poop. All right. Well, we found something new today. We broke the game in an exciting new way. We found out how to stop Gertie Sr. from ever hitting you ever. We did not get a deal with anything, which is, again, really surprising to me. I'm not going to take Super Bandage. I will take the Halo. That was pretty funny. You have to admit, that was pretty funny. Gertie Sr. had no idea what was going on, man. He was just flipping out. He's like, what? Where'd all this poop come from? I can't even move. I can't even shoot the guy. This is unfair. Someone nerf this nerd. I've never seen that happen before. And it worked out good. I mean, Gertie Sr. literally could not hit us because there's a wall of poop that was blocking every single projectile. Hashtag things you can only say in the Binding of Isaac that would make sense to Binding of Isaac players. Alright, so I'm going to use the Fool card just because I have to use everything. And we're done. Very good floor. We ended up getting the Inner Eye and the Halo. Really surprised that we didn't get a Deal with the Devil or Deal with the Angel on this floor. I don't know what's going on with that. Again, we barely took any damage, so... I could blow both of those up, but... Oh, there's a full charge here. I didn't even realize that. Let's go reroll the shop again real quick. That was... What was inside of our item room? Oh, Inner Eye. That's what it was. The Inner Eye. Stopwatch. That would be pretty scummy. I'm not going to do that. I'll take the Sharp Plug. There we go. I believe that there was another soul heart in the curse room, but not really too worried about that. So what the sharp plug does is it allows you to charge up your space bar item at the cost of 2 hearts. And if you get that plus the wafer, that's how I was able to get the real platinum god thanks to Monster Manual. Amplifee is almost literally spawned right on top of us. Our damage is pretty decent, thanks to our followers. The inner eye definitely helps out a bunch. We got the 9-volt, which means that we're going to be able to use our spacebar item a little bit more effectively. And our HP is fantastic. That was a not good play. Wow, this knight is turning around, like, way faster than normal. Mongo Baby and Sister Maggie definitely helping out a bit. No, I'm not going to take that. I'd rather have Liberty Cap. Liberty Cap stock for me, honestly, has been rising. Every single run that I get it, I'm just like, you know, Liberty Cap's not a bad item. Thank you, the soul. You saw that projectile harmlessly bounce away from Isaac there. I'm going to cheese the map and compass. So there is a reroll room on here. Don't know if I'm going to do that. Let's put it this way. If that is a reroll room, I will reroll this run only because of the starter deck snafu. Okay, that was an honest mistake by me. I was not meaning to cheese that. It was a complete accident. The starter deck, like I said, it's one of those items that that has a consequence I don't think about. And that's actually worked out in the past kind of detrimentally because I've had like pills that were really, really good. But I saw the starter deck and I just picked it up instinctively thinking that, oh, I'm just going to get 2 free tarot cards. Then not realizing that it actually turns all pills into tarot cards. So if this is a reroll room, I will reroll before going into the boss room. That is my restitution for that. That is not a character reroll. I think that will reset the floor, though. I always forget what the 6 does. It's the combination of the 3-room, the 4-room, and the 5-room, which is a global D6, a global D20, and it rerolls everything in the room, I believe. It's either that or it starts the floor over again. Like a forget-me-now. So we'll see. I'm going to do the boss first just in case. We've got the soul, and now we have the mind, so I am okay with that. Isaac looks very bored now with this situation. You see how the projectiles kind of just curve away from Isaac. It's not that I think that the soul is bad. It's just not a very good item. It's a mediocre at best item, in my opinion anyway. It's not something that's going to save you on a regular basis. I mean, I'd rather have just a straight up orbital rather than the mind. Or the soul, rather, sorry. I'm always happy to get the mind, that's for sure. You don't have to worry about Liberty Cap. Actually, I'd go back and pick up the Rosary Bead if I wanted to. Curse the Maze is completely screwing with us right now. Look, all I want to do is get in the shot. That's all I want. Well, Black Candle is pretty nice. I will happily take that. Actually, I meant to pick up Black Candle. Somehow, Isaac was able to go past that anyway. Compass, obviously, we don't care about. Let's go do the boss fight. And then we will hit up that 6 room. I don't think that the 6 room is a forget-me-now. I think it only simply does what I just said, was the global D20, global D6, and the D20 inside of the room itself. I believe that's what it does. Judgment, card, and chariot. Go ahead and look at the super secret room as well. Obviously, boss rush not happening. Not that we really cared about it. And an evil heart. All right, so let's see here. I'm going to drop the judgment inside of the reroll room here. Momentarily after we're done beating the gate. So So it is going to be a deal with the Angels. And Sacred Heart again. Wow. Oh, man. That is so good. Sacred Heart again, man. That is beautiful. I don't know what's going on, but Sacred Heart has never shown up this often. It really is not. We get a D6 rune anyway, and two diamonds. Okay, so I'm going to use... Well, I didn't mean to do that. Well, we've got the wafer now. What I actually meant to do was I was trying to use Judgment in here, but I guess I'll go do what I was originally going to do, which was to... By the way, I'm not taking the Lucky Scab. I was going to do what... I wanted to do what I was going to do, which was to use Judgment in the room and then reroll that. But since Judgment's here, it's going to be the Demon Judgment, which is not the Judgment that I wanted to see, to be quite honest. All right, so step on the six, and that did reroll Isaac. So there you go. There you go, Internet. There's Sinvicta's restitution right there. So we lost Sacred Heart. We lost... The D6, we lost... Oh, good, and we have Cursed Eye, too. That's brilliant. We lost the D6, we lost Sacred Heart, we lost Triple Shot, we lost all that other stuff. I assume that we held on to the starter deck, but there you go. Now I don't want to hear any complaining. No, none of this, oh, you copped out, you took the starter deck. Yeah, there you go. I just rerolled Sacred Heart, all right? I kind of halfway knew. Oh, apparently pills are back. And we also have PhD, I guess. And we also have... Is that the... That's got to be three... Yeah, we definitely have $3 bill. $3 bill. Mini Haunt. Or Little Haunt. Abel. Robo Baby. Dry Baby. Headless Baby. Big Fan. Bob's Brain. Aries. $3 bill. And I think that I see Lucky Foot. Is that Luck Foot on... I can't tell what that golden chain is off of Isaac's left foot. Our right, his left. I'm pretty sure that that's Luck Foot. Oh, we also have Scorpio, by the way. That's what the poison effect is. So I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. That is my way of saying I didn't mean to use the starter deck, but now that we're even now. I paid my due. Plus, we have to take pills again. So there you go. You got Internet. You got everything that you guys and gals wanted. Oh, this is gonna be a one run here. You already won the run. This isn't even fun. It's not a challenge. Well, there you go. It's back to being a challenge. Gave up my second favorite item in the game, and the D6, mind you. Which also kind of hurts, and we lost the soul as well as the mind. So I did take Thunder Thighs there just because I would like to get some more evil hearts. That would be an evil heart. I'm pretty sure that we also lost Contract from Below as well. Apparently that is not a. We did retain Liberty Cap though, so I'm glad I didn't get rid of it. I can see forever. Let's go do that in a safer room here. Forgot that we had Stomping for a brief second there. Not sure what hit us. Dry Baby got hit by something. So, of course, Cursed Eye is god-awful. I don't know why Northern Lion likes it so much. I don't think it's a great item. Champion Belt I will absolutely take. I'm really tempted to take Stopwatch, to be honest with everybody. I'm not going to. That was the broken Stopwatch anyway, but I'm not going to. Bombs are key. Sure. With the Cursed Eye plus... Cursed Eye plus $3 bill is scary, though, because if we get... If we end up getting Fire Mind while I'm charging the shot, I'm going to get randomly teleported out of places. Apparently, he's still alive. There we go. That was one heck of a shift there, I got to say. Savage Brain. Isaac's Fork, not gonna be really that much help. I'd love the curved horn here, that would be nice. Two of spades, doubles our keys. Two diamonds, doubles our money. Chariot card. Yeah, that's gotta be luck foot. With the way that this machine's paying out, better luck's pretty high. It's gonna be the Hoggler's Rune. Hey, there's the Cursed Horn. Where did that hurt? I didn't even see the Cursed Horn. Was that in the... Where did that Cursed Horn come from? I don't even know. Anyway, doesn't matter. Let's see. So, Chariot card. I could use the Stars card. There's really no reason for me to do that, though. I'm going to use the Destruction... I'm going to use the Hoggler's Rune inside of this room. And hopefully not get teleported out by Cursed Eye. Cursed Eye Bob's brain is just asking for trouble. I had to pull off the charge there. We did get a deal with the devil. And it is going to be... Do we even have guppy items at this point? I feel like we probably don't, but I'm going to pick it up anyway. Necronomicon, I mean, I might as well take. Just to have something. Forgot to pick up... I thought... Actually, I picked up that sword. Apparently, I didn't. All right. Well, this is certainly a something. I'm a little bit nervous, not gonna lie. What I wouldn't do to have my Sacred Heart back, that's for sure. I kind of knew that the sixth room would do that, but I wasn't 100% positive. I know that the sixth room is the combination of a lot of the rooms, and we got teleported out by Cursed Eye. Which I guess is not that much of a loss, because that room is a dead end anyway. I guess we still have the 9-volt. I really, really wish that we had our mind back. Abel again throwing me off. So I'm pretty happy with the curved horn pickup, which is a trinket that just gives you a straight up damage upgrade. I thought that was Abel shooting that, which is again a reason why I don't like Abel. Yeah, I mean that one spawned underneath us, so we're getting hit by all kinds of hilarious. Does at this point. Let's see, chariot card. I'm gonna use Necronomicon here. I think I could be forgiven for doing so. Thank you, Dry Baby, for slam dunking the alley oop that I gave you. Wow. This run took a turn for the worse very quickly, I've gotta say. So I'm hoping that we get a little bit of help here in this deal with the devil. I have absolutely no idea if and how many guppy items we have. I basically have to do this just to take a chance. It's going to be the pact, or the mark rather, not the pact. I'd love to see the pact. Apparently the mark gives you a soul heart. I did not know that. There we go. I'm not going to take that half heart because I'd like to stay on the half heart interval. There's a pill. I have to take this pill. I'm going to do this the cop-out way. Are you a wizard? Really wish we had the Necronomicon for this room. Hin is also in this room, apparently. This is a very weird room. I'm going to have to rely on Robo Baby for most of this damage. Bob's brain. All right. We've got plenty of keys. Let's see, that is not worth the key that we used. So our chances of getting a deal with the devil here are pretty much nil, just because of how much damage we've already taken. I mean, Teratomo. That's also going to be a small rock, which I will absolutely take. Necronomicon's pretty good against the against Teratomo, I gotta say. And we're just going to go down to the next floor. Oh, baby. I love the way. Oh, we also have Loki's horn, apparently. Do we have Loki's horn, or is that a... No, the $3 bill cannot proc... $3 bill can't proc Loki's horn, can it? I don't think it can. Unless we're just getting really lucky with the Loki's horns proc. I pretty much have to try this here. We also lost the wafer, by the way, which I'm also not too happy about. There's a lot of things that I'm not happy about this run, and it's taking the turn. You all wanted a challenge, though. This is... And I'll be damned if this is not a challenge all of a sudden. All right, Demon Judgment to hang out with a credit card, which is not exactly helpful. Ceremony of Robes is a fantastic upgrade, however. Alright, now if we can get a... If we can get a payout from this blood bank and get the blood bag... Alright, so that worked out beautifully. Alright, I feel a little bit better about our situation now. Our damage went up thanks to the Ceremony of Robes. I mean, how am I supposed to dodge that? Like, seriously. Our damage went up, we got a lot of health. And yeah, I'd love to play this Judgment as well. This is going to be difficult to do without killing him. Well, it's all right. Small Rock, of course, is also a big help. It's always a pleasure to get the Small Rock. And as soon as Lapras decides to show his big stupid head... Five hands. Six hands. I think we'll just use Necronomicon here. I don't really feel bad about doing that. By the way, what the Cursed Eye is, in case if I forgot to mention what it is, the Cursed Eye is charge shots. And if you get hit while the shot is not fully charged, you will be teleported randomly, like the Cursed Skull does, which is a trinket in the game. The reason why I don't like it is because of that very reason. It basically alters the way that you're supposed to play the game, and that's not always conducive with a good time. But again, there's some people who really like the Cursed Eye. I would not happen to be one of those people, but Northern Lion really enjoys the Cursed Eye. I don't know why. How did that hit us? I don't know about that one, game. Game's taking some cheap shots now. So this is as far as we surprisingly have gotten on the challenge runs outside of the... I'm surprised that actually worked. I can see forever. Again, solid. I guess I should just use the credit card now because we're not going to be able to do anything with it. I should have used it technically by the rules of the challenge. I should have used it on that last floor, but it doesn't really matter here. My damage is actually quite good. Tower card. So, would like to get possibly one more Guppy item if we can. If we get lucky in like a curse room or a boss trap room or something on this floor. More greed. Good job, Abel. You did a great job, Abel. We're very proud of you. If all of our shots hit, man, we actually pack a pretty hefty wallop. Again, under the assumption that we don't get teleported out via the cursed skull. Little Haunt, not really doing a whole lot. I mean, I really feel like we gotta go for it. There's Guppy's Paw. That could be the game winner there. We are not Guppy. I'm actually gonna hold on to Guppy's Paw. I think Guppy's Paw makes more sense for us here. Let's see, mob trap room. Should be a piece of cake. I actually wouldn't mind getting teleported out of this room, to be quite honest. But it's not gonna be that big of a deal. Hoping the troll bombs can help us out a little bit. They didn't. So what Guppy's Paw does is it will convert all red hearts that you have. Well, it will convert one red heart container to three soul heart containers. But that's permanent, though. It's not a temporary thing. But the reason why I'm holding on to it is because of the fact that we probably are not going to get a chance to get a whole lot of soul heart generators in the chest. It's a possibility, but I think that Guppy's Paw will save us here. It's unfortunate that we don't have another Guppy item, because that would have been one heck of a lucky get in the cathedral. It's not over yet. Guppy Dream can still happen. Oh boy, range up. Yeah, we've got to have PhD. Health up, absolutely. And tears up. That confirms that we have PhD or Virgo. I'm guessing it's PhD, though, because I've not seen a damage shield. Our damage is quite good. There we go. Just gonna keep on rocking and rolling. See you later, Gertie Jr., you jerk. Finally found Isaac. Oh wow, do we have chocolate milk? We might have chocolate milk with the rate that I'm able to spam the cursed eye. We might have chocolate milk. I'm not seeing Isaac's mouth move, though, is the thing. So we might have chocolate milk and cursed eye, which is not a combination I think I've ever seen before. No, we've got to have chocolate milk there, because I can just rattle this off like a chocolate milk shot, which is a very delicious drink, by the way, chocolate milk shot. Alright, so that worked out pretty good, and we are going into the chest feeling a lot better about ourselves than what it was previously. Guppy's Paw should keep us safe. Gnawed Leaf is a pretty big get. Spectral Tears, Little Gish, Rosary, that's actually kind of a waste there, and I will take the Gnawed Leaf. I'm still gonna hold on to Guppy's Paw, though. So we're going to rattle off that damage. So what Gnawed Leaf does, Gnawed Leaf basically makes you indestructible as long as you don't move. Theoretically, we could do this as a Gnawed Leaf run, but I don't think it's a lot of fun. And honestly, I don't think people would want to see that either. Maybe this was a lost run, maybe, but we are in good shape here. And this should be, hopefully, a one run. Gonna be a Purthrow, no, and two, which I will use right away. So at the end of the day, it doesn't look like us re-rolling our build really mattered. Again, I have to use every single pill, so I might as well do that. And cursed eye, that's what the cursed eye looks like whenever you fire it without charging. Oh, we can't rattle off the shots because we proc'd We proc triple shot in here with the curse with the $3 bill. There we go. Now we're back to normal. And we are just rocking and rolling, machine gunning these noobs down. I will take Mini Mush, just because extra movement speed is always nice. This should just be a slam dunk of a win here. This is a good idea of where our damage is. Obviously, with the stacking poison damage that we can deal with Scorpio, plus our just latent damage with all of our followers, plus Bob's brain, we've got ourselves a one run here. Oh, Gusketeers are so good. And that is just a... That is an epileptic seizure waiting to happen right there. I apologize. Seizure warning. Quarter. It's pretty useful, especially in the chest. And let's just do it. So, very fun challenge overall. I ended up having to take pills anyway after my little goof up of the starter deck. Didn't end up mattering in the end. I still, you guys and gals got to see me take pills. You got to see me reroll Sacred Heart, which is something that would never, ever happen ever again, if I have anything to say about it. And yeah, keep on giving me those ideas for the challenge runs. They are a lot of fun. Looking forward to doing the next one. The next one will be the Golden Door Challenge, where basically I can only use items that I find inside of item rooms. No boss deals, no deals with the devil, and no other random items I can pick up. It's going to be fun. Thank you for watching, everyone. Until next time, so long, everybody.